So this morning I'm gonna give you four confidence building word shifts that can actually change your life. My name is Heather Quizzle, here to help level up your business and level up your life. So confidence building word shifts. This is something that I myself as an entrepreneur, as a woman, as a human, have had to learn how to make certain shifts, certain exchanges in my language pattern that allowed me to be more confident, feel more empowered, and feel like I can actually be in control of my own life. A lot of times, do you notice this? And maybe you know, don't. And this is what I want to bring to your attention today is there's a lot of words in our own language, just how we talk to people, how we talk about our life, our day, our situation, that can be disempowering, meaning you're giving control to outside forces. So the more that we can be thoughtful of the words that we use, and using words that put us in the driver's seat of our lives, that's where your life is gonna change. And it's gonna change in a positive way, where you feel more balanced, you feel more fulfilled, you feel happier, healthier, and truly in control. I don't know about you, but I'm a woman who loves to be in control. So stuff like this is absolutely my jam. So I'm gonna give you four words, four phrases slash words that you really should stop using today. And I guarantee you're gonna hear them and know that you're using all four of them probably every day, if not on the hour, okay? So the first one is busy. I'm just too busy. And when people say, hey, how's it going? Think about it. What is the first thing that you tend to tell people? Oh, it's going good. I'm just so busy. Or I'm just ridiculously busy. We throw out this term busy, and there's a couple things that come from using this word. First, it tends to make us feel good because, I don't know, in our country, being busy equals success. No. No, it doesn't. And the second thing that throwing that out there, it allows you to kind of, I don't know, give away your power. Like, I'm just so busy. I don't have time for this. I can't volunteer because I'm just so busy. I didn't have time to make it to that event I wanted to go to because I'm just so busy, which says I'm so busy doing other things that I don't get to do what I actually want to do. So the first word switch that we're going to do today is I want you to just erase busy from your vocabulary. Just erase and change it with priority. Start using the word priority and see how that feels. So twofold. So first of all, when somebody asks you how you're doing, I'm doing awesome. I've got a lot on my plate and I'm enjoying it, right? When you have a lot on your plate and you're enjoying it, that tells you I'm in control. This is good for me. But it also be by like, I can't make it tomorrow night. I'm too busy. But it could also be, hey, I've got a lot going on tomorrow night myself. I'm not going to be able to make it because I've got other priorities that I'm invested in. You see how that totally changes just how we mentally are filtering our own situation in life. So erase busy from your life, exchange that with priorities, or even that's not how I want to spend my time. But either way, that is going to radically change how you think about your life and your situation. The second word switch, this is a good one, you guys, is I want you to think about how you're using the word hard. Like, this is just so hard. I tried to start a business, but it was just so hard. Like, I never made it through grad school because it was just so hard. I really want that promotion, but that job is really hard. Guys, what does hard mean? Like, what does hard mean? Most of the time, hard things really aren't that challenging at all. What they are, they require dedication. A lot of times hard things require consistency. They require persistency. They require you to commit long term, and they require you to do things day in and day out that maybe aren't fun. But is it hard? No. Most things that we term hard don't require like rocket science. They don't even require hard physical labor, they require commitment and dedication. So instead of using that sounds really hard, instead of using that word, that phrase, try using the word dedication. Like, this is something I'm gonna have to dedicate some time to. Let me consider if I wanna dive into that. You know, this is gonna require some dedication. Am I up to what it's going to require? When you make that word switch, you stop telling yourself that you can't do hard things, and you start coaching yourself that this requires dedication, and you get a choice if you choose to dedicate to that or not. The third word is problem. Well, I've just got this problem. I've got a situation. It's just a problem. This is a problem. He's a problem. My kid's a problem at school. We use this problem and we kind of subconsciously believe that it's a problem that we aren't in control of. If you take that word out and instead use the word challenge, like this really challenged me. Like, okay, we've got a situation. Here's the challenge. Let's work to overcome it. You know, let's work to figure it out. Whereas when you have a problem that has a negative connotation, it tends to insinuate that you might not have the skills to fix it. But when you're challenged, our minds are always up for a challenge, always up for learning something new, always up for stretching ourselves to see how far we can go. So take the word problem out of your vocabulary. Stop looking at your life as a problem and start looking at things that come your way as a situation, as a challenge, something to sink your teeth into and work to solve. That's going to make a big difference for you. And lastly, you guys, I cannot wait to share this last one with you because this one word shift has dramatically changed my life, especially when it comes to money. How many of you were raised with the phrase of, we can't afford that? I just can't afford that. Hey, do you want to go on vacation with us? Yeah, we just can't afford it. Or I would really love to buy this pair of Hudson jeans, but we just can't afford it. Or I would love to be able to get my kids everything they want for Christmas, but I can't afford it. This comes out of our mouth so easily. And what it means is you're not in control of money. It means that you can't. You're limited. You're a victim because you can't do something. You have something in your way of actually getting what you want. So if we take that phrase, I can't afford it, we can't afford it, take that off your plate and instead switch that around with, that's not where I'm choosing to spend my money at this moment. It's gonna radically change your life. It's gonna radically change your life. Because most things that we say we can't afford, if you look at the money you have in the bank or what's in the checkbook, you could actually afford it if you wanted to. But you in your mind have other things that you want to spend that money on instead, which means you're in control when you think about it that way. And once you start thinking about money as something that you're in control of, you get to choose what you do with it. You get to choose when it comes to you, when you spend it, when you go to work, when you hold it, when you let go of it, and what you let go of it on. That's where you start to key into what your real priorities are, and that sense of empowerment, that sense of confidence, like I have this money, I could spend it to go here, to do this, to buy whatever, but I'm choosing to spend that money elsewhere today. That gives you the power, the onus. Because I'm a firm believer that when you feel in control of your life, that's when you feel happiest, that's when you feel healthiest, that's when you feel most positive and confident about yourself and the choices that you're making. So I hope that these four word switches can help radically change your life as they have done mine. So quick recap, get the words problem, busy, hard, and I can't afford off your plate and choose something else that's more empowering when you move forward. You guys are gonna kill it and I can't wait to hear your stories from it. All right, if you listened to this video and you can think of somebody who would also benefit from this, just drop their name in the comments below, tag them here. And guys, you can keep up to date on all of the episodes I do Monday through Friday without ever having to scroll through the newsfeed or look back to try and keep up. Just go to heatherquizzle.com/live to never miss an episode. All right, you guys, love you madly. Thanks for being here with me this morning and have a great day. Mwah.